In the studio, I'm now joined by Hayley Ivins-Downes. She's head of property at Lightstone, and we want to talk about foreign interest in the local property market. They have produced a report with some surprising and some interesting insights. Thanks for coming through, Hayley.
Great.
Let's give the big picture. What are you seeing in terms of trends? And you are measuring here since the beginning of the year.
Yes. So Godfrey, just in terms of foreign ownership in terms of property, maybe just to start off by saying that it's really a small percentage.
Right.
We're looking
at local market.
Of the bulk of the market. So your transactions that happen, your registrations over an annual period,
yeah,
we're looking at 1 to 2%, which are foreign ownership,
okay,
essentially coming in.
Okay. What just in case Julius comes by,
yes,
in and saying, hello,
yes,
you're laying the red carpet,
yes,
blah, blah.
Yes.
Go on.
So essentially what we're seeing is a comparison to last year, 2017, the beginning start of the year, January to March, we've picked up a big increase. And our sense on it is possibly linked to the whole ramaphoria,
right,
that happened in the country. We saw a spike that started kind of happening from quarter three, end of quarter three, happening through to now March.
Right.
For us, we kind of saying it's a reflection of what's happening in South Africa,
right,
at the moment.
Yeah.
Our focus going forward, though, and our prediction is that it's definitely going to be dropping again.
Okay.
There's a lot of heat and questions around land expropriation,
right,
which is understandable.
Yeah.
And we've seen the growth in the foreign ownership, still in your Cape Town, still,
yeah,
in your Johannesburg,
yeah,
still the two nodes where you anticipate and foresee them being there.
Yeah, and we're going to come back and talk a little more detail about how this market is likely to pan out going forward. I wanted to talk a little bit more about the context, mm-hmm, of the period that we're looking at, mm-hmm, last year, because this was Jacob Zuma,
yes,
still in the hot seat,
yes,
very much ensconced and very much looking like he could direct the outcome of the succession battle in the African National Congress.
Yes.
So we're comparing a very low base, mm-hmm, against what was a complete turnaround in fortune. So we need to understand that.
Yes, and essentially remember your property sales is one of the first indication in terms of what's happening across the country, what's being seen by foreigners in terms of investment.
Right.
So if we look at the beginning of last year, it's exactly to your point. There was a sense in terms of we're not sure whether we should be investing in South Africa. We,
yeah,
definitely started seeing a dip in the property market.
Yeah.
And in actual fact, there was possibly a slight increase overall going forward, but not in the foreign ownership.
Okay.
And definitely the change with Ramaphosa when he came through, and we saw that.
Yeah.
So it's automatically almost seems to be kind of one of the main factors,
yeah,
that drives the purchase of property.
Excellent. We've got 4 minutes, so I want to cover as much ground as I can. Let's talk about where this money was going through in those first 3 months of the year.
Okay.
You said Cape Town.
Cape Town.
You said Johannesburg.
Cape Town, Johannesburg. So those are the big spikes that we've seen. So, and your Cape Town are your suburbs that we know.
That's what I was going to say. So what did they buy? Did they buy Soweto?
No. So Cape Town was very much your Sea Point,
yeah,
your kind of your Camps Bay, actually extending up the Bloberg side, so kind of your Parkview area, which is beautiful in terms of views.
Right.
Then in Johannesburg, it's very much around your business hub of Sandton.
Right.
So it's very much your Bryanston's, your Morningside's, your Lone Hill. We saw an uptick in those suburbs specifically from,
yeah,
foreign buyers.
And the price bands?
Price bands, all luxury, kind of your upper end market,
uh-huh,
that we see that they're buying into.
Right.
For them, it's very affordable. You know, a foreign buyer coming into this country compared to a pound coming in or a dollar coming in.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, you
it's
get a really good property.
So we're talking what? 2 million, 3 million?
I would say
to what?
Probably kind of your 3 million up.
3 million up?
Yes.
That's where,
yes,
your interest is going for. Let's talk,
yes,
going forward now, because,
yes,
we have since seen a calm down, if you like, around the whole Ramaphosa thing. I mean,
mm-hmm,
I had the excitement of having Brian Joff in studio with me when the Rand was running, when he,
yes,
was saying to me, the R in the Rand represents Ramaphosa. I don't know if he still holds the same view now, but we have seen a sea change in,
yeah,
sentiment.
We have.
How does that affect interest in our local property market?
So I think there's already a dampener starting to be seen in the property, the purchases coming through.
Sure.
We have a lag in the sense that the deeds office is almost a 3 month lag.
Okay.
We'll be able to kind of give a really good picture probably September, October,
okay,
in understanding what that effect is actually, what's actually happening.
Right.
But our sense, we can feel it in the property market already,
yeah,
that there's a dip.
Uh-huh.
So if there's a dip locally, there's going to be a dip internationally.
Absolutely.
Is kind of the sense.
Yeah.
So it is dropping, and I think people are expecting more at the moment, and they're not getting a sense of more from the country.
Yeah.
So investment is once again kind of going,
yeah,
do we need to stay off or come
go.
Back in?
Or, yeah, or stay away. Yeah. Is that to do with the noise around expropriation of land without compensation? I mean, we've got to...
That would be our understanding, yeah. And that's probably something that would one of the factors definitely making kind of a noise around it.
Yeah.
The other factor is obviously the world market.
Yeah.
I mean, there's
of course,
so many changes happening around prices for trade and all of that. So I think internationally, we're looking at an economy that's kind of hesitant at the moment for spending anywhere, is my sense.
We're talking property in general. We have sort of focused more on your urban property.
But
does the survey cover rural property, farms, etc.?
No, in actual fact, it's predominantly urban.
Right.
Very little farms that get purchased by foreigners. They do get purchased, but it's not the quantum that we're seeing in the urban areas.
Yeah. And in terms of that foreign interest, how important is it for, if you like, stimulating our market or perhaps just adding to a livelier market?
Well, I mean, it definitely encourages sales within the property
right.
environment, which is really great for us.
Yeah.
And to bring, obviously, that interest of foreigners coming in, with foreigners, possibly more tourists.
Yeah.
So more people visiting. So I think it's very important.
Absolutely. Maybe a conversation to be had with Julius Malema. Thanks, Dave. Hi, Hayley, for coming through.
Thank you. Thanks,
Godfrey. Thank you. That's Hayley Ivins-Downes, Head of Property at Lightstone.